Against a career for highlighting this very interesting new issue. Our next speaker, Professor Dean Shukri, Professor of Forensic Medicine and Toxicology, Qasr Al-Aini Hospital. Medical legal aspects of diabetes in brats. Professor Dean.
Hi, good morning everybody, chair and floor. I'm going to take you in the next 12 minutes to another area of medicine, another area of diabetes management. It's not a pathogenesis or the study of management of diabetes, but it is the medical legal aspect in attempt to share the same objective of the old physicians, a way to patient safety. The outline of my presentation is the diabetes as a model of medical legal concern, legal codes in Egypt, medical legal practice, medical errors and responsibility related to diabetes, documentation in medical practice, stem cell therapy in management of diabetes, and finally tips just to have some insight about how to reduce malpractice litigation. To start with the diabetes, it's deeply rooted in history, and when you navigate through history, you are always find the ancient Egyptian. There is an ailment suspected to be a diabetes within the era of ancient Egyptian, back to 1550 BC, and it was called as a sweet urine disease. As for the prevalence of diabetes, as Dr. Ines said early in the morning, that Egypt, located at the 8th of the top 10 countries for the number of adult diabetes. And according to the IDF, Egypt will face the explosive growth of diabetes within 2025. Of course, there is a lot of complications and comorbidities accompanying the management of diabetes. So it is a perfect model for the medical legal concern because it's a chronic disease with a comorbidity, a lot of complications, and with a very high prevalence in Egypt and internationally. So what are the medical legal aspects of diabetes? When we start to speak about the medical laws, back to the history again, we have to remember Hammurabi. Hammurabi was the first to issue medical laws in history. He is the king of Babylon, 2,000 years before century. And the one to the right, he is the Abbas Helmi Basha the first, and he was the first to issue medical laws in the region in 1851. So when we practice medicine, we have two concerns: ethics or medical ethics and law. So what about ethics? During your practice, you have to follow and implement the basic and core ethical principles, which are beneficence, non-maleficence, justice, and respect of personal autonomy. Or, to do good, not to harm, to be fair, and to respect the choices of your patients. So what about the laws? The laws that govern medical practice within Egypt, they are two main sets of laws. The first one, or the first set of laws, are the statute laws, which include the penal codes, the criminal law, the civil law, the code of criminal procedure. And the other set of law is the medical laws. The two important laws that govern the medical practice in Egypt are the profession ethics regulation, number 238, for the last updated in 2003, and the other one is the law number 415 to the year 1954 for the practice of medical profession. So what about the medical error, malpractice, and medical responsibility? In order to have a lawsuit in medicine, so you have to fulfill these four elements. The first one is the physician should owe the patient a duty of care. there is a breach of a standard of care, there is an injury or damage, and there is a proximate cause between the negligence, incompetence, and this injury or damage. So what about the types of medical malpractice? We do have three main types. The first one is negligence, or the lack of care, incompetence, lack of skill, and professional misconduct. For the negligence, you have to do one of these, either to omit an important issue within the medical practice, like informed consent or investigation or treatment modality, or to commit something like the unnecessary treatment, abandonment, which is the unethical unilateral termination of doctor-patient relationship, or assault or battery. So the medical liability is either civil for the patient, or for the sake of the patient or plaintiff, and the criminal for the sake of the community as whole. We have to remember that damage is not equivalent to the bad outcome. And according to the law, we are not penalized for the common complications, but we are a subject of penalty if there is the negligence or misconduct or incompetence. On the other hand, 44% of the serious medical events were preventable. This means that 44% of those claimed to be non-complications were negligent medical errors. So we have to take care. Finally, I'm going to speak about the professional misconduct. A lot of examples of the professional misconduct. The one I want to throw light on is the practicing frailty, to use the non-registered way of treatment. This is considered as misconduct. The professional misconduct, or the professional misconduct, is subjected the doctor for a set of penalties which is called administrative and disciplinary penalties, which are alarm, warning, blame, and temporary revocation of the medical registry. The temporary revocation of the medical registry also extended to the criminal offense and cases of malpractice and medical error. Registration could be achieved after at least 2 years. How to reduce malpractice litigations? Establish good communication with your patient, and this is very crucial point. Continuous training and support expertise, and very important two issues, informed consent and documentation. So I'm going to throw light on the legal frame of documentation within the medical practice. Why documentation? Documentation is very important to achieve development of the healthcare, the quality of healthcare, to develop the research, and of course for legal protection. Types of medical reports are primary, progress report, and final discharge instruction sheet. It's a very important legal document and should include the following information: details of management and complications, recommendations and follow-up plan, and signature from the patient and doctor. The medical report should include correct and detailed true data, and of course it might having no conflict of interest between the doctor and the patient, and if the doctor take fees in return to this report, it is considered by Egyptian law as a malpractice. The medical reports should be issued by a specialized doctor according to the Article Number 7, Professional Ethics and Regulation, and should be conform and following the guidelines of medical reports that was written in the Ministerial Decree Number 187 to the year 2001. And if there is any in non-true data or any deceiving of writing the information of the patient, the doctor will be a subject of penalty according to the Penal Code Number 85. Informed consent. Informed consent is a legal mandate by the Egyptian law, Article 28, it is of many forms, implied consent, which cover the history taking and general examination, express consent, which either oral consent for the entrance examination, PVMTR, and written examination in cases of intervention or surgery. We do have what we call implied consent, which cover a lot of medical procedure within the healthcare facility, and this is legally deficient if the case carry a risk for the patient or if there is a kind of alternatives for the patient management. Consent is not a template to let the patient sign, but it is a process starting with volunteerness and competence. As for the age of the patient, and in Egypt, the age of consent is 18 years, and the mental capacity, or otherwise, the doctor should take what we call a proxy consent from the legal guardians. Disclosure of information, all information about the disease and management, and you have to assure the understanding of each tiny information about the disease and management from your patient and relatives, and finally, consent. In order to be valid, the consent should include the following information: nature of the disease, chances for success, risks, adverse effects of any, reasonable alternative, and consequences of deciding not to follow this treatment and proceedings. So, kindly consider the common doctor's pitfall in the treatment of diabetes. Failure to follow guidelines. As for drugs, if you prescribe drugs of the same pharmacological group with the same mechanism of action, failure to adjust the dose of the drug according to the renal function, and as Dr. Ines said earlier, not considering the liver function when prescribing drugs, aggressive start with insulin therapy with high doses, misdiagnosis of diabetic emergencies, for instance, the diagnosing hypoglycemia causing neuroglycopenia as a psychiatric disorder, or diagnosing diabetic ketoacidosis as surgical abdomen, not implementing patient education, delay of the treatment, discontinuation of the treatment when the blood sugar became normal. Paying no attention to diabetes comorbidities such as dyslipidemia and hypertension. In gestational diabetes, use of drugs that are not approved, such as DPP-4 inhibitors. In type 1 diabetes, do not use the drugs that are not approved for ages below 18 years. Here is one of the guidelines. And I want to draw attention to the defined issue in the stem cell therapy within the diabetes. What are the situation in Egypt? In Egypt, the stem cell in general, not approved or registered as a modality of treatment, so it should be regulated according to the Egyptian clinical trial regulation. So you have to take the approval of the Institutional Review Board and the National Research Ethics Committee, Ministry of Health and Population, and you don't have to take fees in return, and this clinical trial should be done and conducted in the approved and registered CRC or clinical research center. Finally, a statement of policy. Every healthcare facility should have a rating policy appropriate for its scope. That is evidence-based and drives continuous quality improvement related to diabetes and complications risk assessment, prophylaxis, diagnosis, and treatment. The final word, you have to remember that it is not the one you anticipate that gets you into trouble, but the one you never expect. Thank you.
بعد ما كنا